How you doing?
Hi.
Okay, a couple more here. Here it comes. Give it. Down. Good. Walk up to the dog. Down. Back away from the dog. Badger, come. Here comes Josh. Get him.
I want you to hear the collar set to an audible tone, so you're going to hear when it goes on. Losh. Yes. Losh. Yes. Losh. Comes on, if commanded, the kennel, the only way to shut off the e-collar is to run to rebiting is going to be a consequence. Your collar will come back on. That consequence is going to be enough of a punishment that he's going to avoid it. He's going to go for that comfort zone. Once he gets to the kennel, I shut off the e-collar. Once I say get him, he's permitted to come out. If I give another command, he must listen to it or else there's a consequence. So he's been patterned to understand that go in that place when commanded to or else there's going to be a consequence. Once he's released, he's going to get his reward. Punishment, reward, punishment, reward. And the way that we got there is I left the door open and I would run a thin rope through the grate on the window on the opposite door. So the door closest to us is open. The opposite door is closed. The grate on the window. Run the rope through it. So the rope comes out and then it's attached to the dog on this end. Somebody holds the dog back so they don't creep into the kennel. The handler then goes to the opposite side of the car, holds on to the rope, and at the same time with their e-collar, they pull. This is the leash with rope. This is the e-collar. It's kennel. So we're giving direction into the kennel. And as soon as that dog gets in that kennel, then they're released. Or they're given another command. In this case, I'll do the down or sit or something else. But if I teach them, get there, release, reward. Get there, release, reward. If you do that through repetition, the dog then understands that that's what they're supposed to be doing. Now they're subordinate to the command rather than the collar itself. The proof of that is, if I take that collar off, he's going to do it. Now, the thing to remember is that this is just one thing that you can do. Later on, I'm going to do something where I'm going to have my decoy working in a bite suit, and I will send the dog on the bite, and I'll work around a position of cover and call the dog to me. I will get out, and I will move to a different spot, and I'll send the dog on the bite. I'll call him to a heel. I'll do different things to increase the intensity of the exercise while still maintaining control. So again, the dog likes to bite. I use a bite sleeve for this. He likes to bite, so there's a payoff for the response. There's a consequence for not responding, for not obeying the command. The equipment matters. This is a very good collar, but even if I switch to another collar, he's going to remember that, and he's going to respect that collar. He's going to respect the command. So at this point, the equipment matters, but since we've conditioned him properly, it matters less. Makes sense now, but if you start with a piece of equipment that isn't going to give you the results you want, you're never going to get to the point where you need to be. You need to start with something that's going to work well and give you the results that you want. And then the dog understands.